The default account which we set up during the initial configuration of Blue Prism is the admin account. It is strongly recommended not to use the admin account for a development purpose. As a matter of fact, you should never use the admin account unless it is absolutely necessary. And should you need to create user accounts and provide them with the necessary permissions by assigning them to the appropriate roles. So I'm going to create a new user account, and from now on I'll be using only that account. To create a new user account, go to the System tab and click Users under Security. On the right hand side you will see all the available user accounts. But at the moment we only have one user account, which is the admin account that we created during the initial setup. Select the admin account, click Edit, and under Roles and Permissions, we can see that the admin account is assigned the role of System Administrator, which has all the permissions. Let's close this for now, and I'm going to create a new account by clicking New, and I'll enter the username as Arun Nair, then type a password, and click Next. Here we need to set an expiry date for the account and an expiry date for the password. You can specify the duration of the password so it expires every time it completes this duration, just the same way the Windows password expires at your work. I'm going to set the account expiry and password expiry to 31st December. Then click Next. Here I need to specify the role I want to assign this user account. I'll select the developer role, which gives full access to Process Studio and Object Studio, which is all we need at the moment to create a process. Then I click Finish. And the user account is created successfully. Now I'm ready to log in with the new user account. So I'll sign out from Blue Prism by clicking the sign out button at the bottom left corner, and then enter the new username and password and click sign in. Now you can see, except for the home and studio tabs, rest of the tabs are grayed out. In the next video, we will discuss about Process Studio and how to create a simple process.